Hey guys, welcome back once again to The Legend of Dragoon. It's been a while since I uploaded a video. I was having some issues with the recording software that I'm currently using, but I think I figured it out. So what we're going to do in this video is hopefully get a bunch more Stardust, as well as hopefully get a couple more trophies. So let's go ahead and make our way to Crystal Palace here in Deningrad. It's always jumping around between discs, it seems, depending which area you're going to. Okay, let's check this house. Actually, I don't think there's anything in here. No. Well, I'm kind of stuck here now. There we go. Okay, we need to find the inn. I think right here. Oh no, this isn't the inn. Now that I'm thinking about it, I guess we don't have access to the Stardust yet. Let's actually check out this shop. There's going to be an event that happens later and then the Stardust will open up to us. So we got an item shop and a weapon shop here. Tomahawk for 300. There we go. So now, with Dart having the Armor of Legend as well as the Legend Cask, basically, right there makes him invisible. Invincible, I mean, not invisible. And we also will be, I think, let me just double check. Yeah, so both are on Dart, so we're good to go. Let's see what the item vendor has to sell. Healing fog, we already have a lot. I think we should sell some stuff. Actually, let's quickly buy. A mind purifier, and we will sell. We'll sell these magic. We don't. These magic items we don't need. I'm going to get rid of these recovery balls because we don't need them. They're pretty much useless. Okay, so that should be good. I think we get another voiced cutscene here too, which is really sweet. So we'll go with yes, please.
The divine tree is the tree of life. All life comes from this divine tree. In the beginning, nothingness filled the world. Then the Creator saw, descended from the sky. And his followers created the world. In the end, Soa sowed a seed on the earth. The seed soon grew to be a great tree. The great tree bore 108 fruits, and various life forms arose from the ripened fruits. Thus, 108 forms of life were created to fill the world. Divine tree completed its role, but the story says it is still protected by the signet of Soa.
Yeah, and from what I remember, I think the story starts to become very convoluted from here on out. It can be quite hard to follow. Alright, and they already talked about what our next goal is, and that's to go to the library. Which is up here, I believe. I just quickly want to check and see if we can pick up at least one of these stardust. Should be... No, I guess we don't have access to it. But anyway, here's a save point, so let's quickly save. I'm going to quickly use this mind purifier on Kongle. Actually, we'll use it on Albert. We'll buy another one for Kongle soon. Let's go inside the library. Oh. Never mind, it's locked. Well, what the heck? Now I need to figure out where to go. We probably have to talk to somebody, I think. Nobody in here. I don't think we talked to any of them. Honestly, it's probably just we have to leave the city or something, is my guess. Maybe not. Let's see. Nope, that's where we go. Well, we're obviously missing out on a conversation or something. Maybe it's one of these people. No. That's the bad thing about these JRPGs, is usually there's one little simple thing you have to do in order to move the story forward, and it never usually tells you what it is. Alright, I just figured it out. We completely missed a character at the front of the library that we're supposed to talk to. Right here. There we go. So this library section of the game here can be, it takes a little while because there's a lot of dialogue involved. Alright, now we can make our way to the library, finally. I don't remember if there's a puzzle in the library or not. It might just be a situation where we have to talk to everybody. Albert's in his zone. Yeah, so at this point, just walk around and talk to everybody, I think. As I said, there's a lot of dialogue here. That's Kongol done. Now we'll talk to Shanna. Alright, now we'll talk to Albert, I suppose. He just loves the library. Oh, there was a ladder. Thank you. should be almost done this, I think. Shouldn't take too long, any longer, I think. I don't believe that we have to talk to the librarian, but we might have to. Nope. Well, maybe we do. Hayshel putting him in his place. I feel like a lot of this dialogue is just repetitive, says the same thing over and over again. Alright, so now it should cut us to... Oh, maybe not. I thought it was going to jump us to Rose right away. We'll say yes again.
Legend says the Moon Child revives the gods on Earth and purifies the world. The black monster abhors, hates, and despises it, and kills the Moon Child. This sad karma is endless. This god stays forever in the sky, and the world is a never-ending chaos.
There we go, now it jumps us to Rose. Once we come back here with Dart, there will be a Stardust here as well, but for now we will basically finish this area very quickly. And there's Sister Luanna, who they were talking about earlier. That's the other survivor of the destruction of Neat. So you can see the black monster here is asking about the princess from that ghost ship that we were on earlier. I think, anyway. Very sad. Oh, and I didn't realize it jumped straight into Maru. Yeah, this is where we find out quite a bit about her backstory. Yeah, so in this area, there's these little teleporters that you can activate to run around the map. It can get a little confusing later on because there's tons of dead ends and stuff like that. Everybody's scared of her. Yeah, so clearly these guys don't like humans. Yeah, they definitely don't like Maru. Thank you. That sounds badass. The Divine Dragon. So I believe that's the sword that Lavith, or not Lavith's, Lloyd killed Lavith with. The Dragon Buster, what they're referring to. So our party should be getting back together here, and then we can finally do a little bit of fighting, I think. But maybe not. This video might just be dialogue, sadly. But once this is out of the way, then we'll be able to fight a couple bosses. Okay, so I'm a little confused as what to do now, so we will just leave the city here, I think. That's exactly what we had to do. All right, here we go. This is an amazing cutscene. Probably one of the most memorable in the game, I think. Epic. I can't remember if there's another cutscene involving that dragon or not, but it's pretty amazing. Oh, there's Maru. So the full party's back together. Okay, I think we'll go with Albert, and I think we'll keep Hachel in the party for now. Let's quickly save, and then I think there's probably a couple more conversations we'll do before we end this video. I don't think we can pick up our Stardust yet. That'll probably be in the next video is my guess. This is one of my favorite musical pieces in the game as well. So if we go up this path to the left, there should be a treasure chest in here somewhere. That has an item. Holy ink. Revive from death. So if one of our characters dies, they'll basically be brought back. So we'll put that on Hayshul just in case. Trying to think if there's anything. I don't think there's any stardust. No. No, I think that's basically all there is up here. Well, there's another room up here. Doesn't look like there's anything in there. Yeah, Miranda, she's kind of a badass as well. If her additions weren't so useless, I think she would actually be a really great addition to the party, but really the only reason to have her is her buffs that she can give you. Maru just kind of outs herself. That's so funny. The sword that the bastard used to kill Lavith. See, sometimes they refer to it as the Dragon Buster, and then I think they refer to it as something else earlier. So it can be kind of confusing. The Dragon Blockstaff. So to get that, we do have to fight, at least from my memory, a pretty difficult boss. So I think because this video I recorded here was full of so much dialogue, I think what we'll do is we'll keep going for a little bit longer just so we can get some battles in and stuff like that. Possibly pick up a few Stardust as well on our way to the Forest of Winglies. So Shanna should be in this room, I think. Maybe not. Might be the second hallway. Yeah. Where did she stay in the... No, she's up in the main room, I think.
Thank you.
So it basically transfers the power onto Miranda. It's kind of sad, I guess. Lighten up. They did a good job with the timing of these trophy pops, honestly. So we'll keep the party as is. And as I said earlier, we don't have access to any of the Stardust in Deningrad yet. We have to come back later and pick them up, but we'll move to an area that's basically optional, I think, from what I remember. Okay, we're gonna save here just in case. We don't want to have to go through all that dialogue again. Yeah, so you'll know you can pick up the Stardust when there's like debris everywhere and there'll be some weapon vendors here out on the streets and stuff like that. Now we just have to figure out how to get to Neat. I think we have to go through... I'm trying to think. I'm pretty sure we go through one of the... Can we take that shortcut? No. I'm pretty sure we have to go through to the... Hang on a second. It's not this way, I don't think. Actually, it might be. Because now that we have Miranda in our party, I think we can move this knight out of the way. Okay, I haven't played this for a while, so I might struggle with Haeschel's move. Darn it. Okay, let's see if we can do this. Aw. Couldn't even get the first hit. Come on. I don't know how I'm so good at Albert, honestly. I think just from using him so much as a kid, I think it's just kind of like ingrained in my memory. Okay, let's let Dart finish him off with his... That's what it's called. I was gonna say Crush Dance, but Crush Dance is his previous one. Oh no, we can't yet. Nope. Okay, where does this lead us? Oh, right. That's where we fought the wolf. I think we go to the right. And then that should lead us to Neat. Out this way where that other character was, I forget his name. Oh, I missed that one. That one's actually kind of hard to time if you aren't careful. Uh-oh. Some of their moves are so strong. Come on. What did that do? It's gonna stop Dark from doing something. Okay, I think... Oh, wrong way. This way. Nope. Maybe not. I can't remember how to get to Neat. It's bugging me. Oh my gosh. Oh, it didn't kill him. Okay. Oh no, we did go the right way. There we go. So the Stardust should be right here. And I think that's the only thing in this town, really. Yeah, there's nothing else to do here. It's pretty much the only thing. So now we will make our way to the Forest of Winglies. How do we even... Nope. Oh, darn it. That one's so hard to pull off when you're not used to it. Gotta practice a few times. We need to get a mind purifier for Dart as well now. Wow, can't believe it's not dead yet. Okay, so if we continue straight, I think, up this way, should lead us to the dead end that has a doorway. Alright guys, and on that note, we now have the entrance unlocked, so I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. So I'm really enjoying this walkthrough so far. I'm really excited to get to the platinum. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in part, I think we're going to be on part 15 or 16 now, so we're plugging away. Take care guys, and I'll see you next time.